Hello there, and welcome to the first video that I will be sending you. I'm Tyler, otherwise known as T. Blake Braddy, and this is my mailing list. The reason I'm sending you these videos is to get to know you a little bit. I'm a writer, and I send emails, and I have books with covers, but that's not very personal, so I thought it'd be nice to send a video just to let you know a little bit about who I am so that you can get to know me, and at the end, I'll ask you can send me emails and we can start a dialogue. That's kind of what one of the reasons why I started writing books was to get to know an audience, to share my love of reading and passion for writing with other people. So the purpose of this video is to give you 5 things that you almost definitely don't know about me as a writer. And the first thing is that I tried to write my first book when I was in the 4th grade, or maybe 5th grade. It was called The Bridge, and it was based on just me plagiarizing R.L. Stine and Christopher Pike and Richie Tankersley Cusick, all those writers that if you're around my age, I'm about to be 37, these are the people I read on a daily basis when I was in 4th grade. I loved suspense novels about teenagers and R.L. Stine's kind of spooky 1950s science fiction stuff. You know, he calls himself the training bra for Stephen King, and I definitely think that's true. So I loved the Goosebumps series, the Fear Street series, and for that reason, I thought, even at a young age, I thought, I can write something. I can do something like this. So my story was about a group of teenagers who had a haunted bridge, and they were getting killed off one by one by the bridge, and because I didn't know what I was doing, I never finished it. I never figured out what was wrong with or spooky about the bridge, but I did have some characters get killed off, and that started my whole writing journey that's led me to this point right here. The second thing that you might not know about me, number 2, is that I hold not 1, not 2, but 3 degrees from the University of Georgia. I'm a Georgia guy, born and bred, and I got degrees in English, journalism from UGA, and I graduated simultaneously with both degrees. At first, I wanted to be a journalist, maybe a TV journalist. I thought myself being an editor or maybe someone who made documentaries for news organizations. But when I graduated in 2005, the job market wasn't amazing, and I had become obsessed with writing. It was something that I picked up in college again after a few classes at UGA. And so I thought I'd try my hand at writing. So I spent a couple years kind of bumming around Athens, Georgia, and writing until I decided to go back to school to get my master's in education, where that's where I got my 3rd degree. So I have 2 undergraduate degrees from the University of Georgia and 1 graduate degree. So go Dawgs. If you're from another school in the SEC or don't care about that at all, I hope we can still be friends. I love people from all schools, even Auburn and Florida. So Georgia Tech people, you might have to email me first, but that's who I am. Which leads me to number three. Because I'm a Georgia guy, I grew up in a small town, and so I based the first book in my Rolston McCain series, Boogie House, on my hometown of Soperton, Georgia. It's a pretty small place. I graduated with 81 people from the only public high school in the town. There's probably 6,000 people in the entire county. So it's a super small town, Troutland County, if you want to go Google map it. And yeah, it's known as the Million Pine City, which is one reason why I named my fictional Georgia universe Lumber Junction. So the first book in the series is based on my hometown, and I have a few other stories that are also based out of Lumber Junction, because it's kind of like I stole that from Stephen King, who has Derry, Maine as kind of the pseudo hometown of his. So I wanted a place where I could play around with these really dark ideas and not feel like I would offend anybody from where I grew up, because there is no real things there. There are no real people from this place. And so I thought I could get away with more if I made up my own town. Now, the fourth thing that I wanted to tell you is that, speaking of stories based in Lumber Junction, before I tried my hand at the Rolson McCain series in Boogie House, I wrote 7 different novels that probably won't ever see the light of day. They were, you know, kind of my attempts to try to write a novel. And so I was figuring out craft, and I didn't just immediately publish the first thing that I wrote, which, lucky for me and you, that didn't happen. I love those early books that I wrote, but they're not things that I'd want to publish, I don't think. So the first one was called The Hunger's Artist. Yeah. Yeah. That is college me who wrote that book, which I'm still the same guy. I'm in the same skin and all of that, but that was a completely different person than who I am now as a writer. So it was kind of a pretentious horror novel about a writer who ate his fans. It was super weird. And I guess that I still write those kinds of stories. They just aren't called The Hunger's Artist, which is in itself an allusion to an old Franz Kafka story. So there's that. Okay. And I think I'm up to number 5. The final 5th of these. And so the very last thing I want to give you as kind of a parting idea is, who influenced me as a writer? Who am I as a writer? I'm Southern. I write spooky stories that have a little bit of the supernatural. They could be considered kind of horror or horror light, or like horror suspense, or, you know, mystery novels with a touch of the supernatural. There is definitely some dark imagery there. There's the Southern Gothic. So beyond the people I would aspire to be, like William Faulkner or Cormac McCarthy, or even Flannery O'Connor, those are people I, let's just say they're in the upper echelon. There are a few people that my works can be kind of comparable to and related to. And one of them is James Ellroy. I became obsessed with James Ellroy shortly after college. My roommate in college actually was a huge fan of his. And I didn't pick up his books because I thought, you know, I've seen L.A. Confidential. I know what the story is, but I never knew how much depth and just wonderful imagery and sharp writing. I didn't know what that could be until I started reading James Ellroy. And my book, Dirt Merchant, the third book in the Rolson McCain series, is most closely related to the works of James Ellroy. It's a big, dense crime novel that has a murder mystery wrapped up into it, and it's a beast of a book. It's like 600 pages, and I think that it compares favorably to the works of James Ellroy, but that could just be my ego. The second book I'm going to show you is by another writer. This person is my absolute idol, and that is James Lee Burke. This is Black Cherry Blues, first book that James Lee Burke won the Edgar Award for, and his Dave Robichaux series is definitely a huge inspiration for me in the Rolson McCain series, because I wrote Boogie House, The Devil Came Calling, Dirt Merchant, and 6 Feet South should be out sometime soon. Those are all really my attempt to create a first-person narrator with a lot of personal problems, but at heart, a really good sense of morality and heart. That is really important to me in creating characters. And Suicide Blondes even has that same issue with a character who is definitely flawed, but someone who has a good sense of morality at her core. And so also the thing with James Lee Burke is there's a touch of the supernatural, not quite as much as I put into my books. And I think there's a reason for that. I wanted to take this idea that like we have a sense of kinship with the supernatural, with the other side of the void. And I just kind of ramped it up a little bit, which brings me to my final person that I'm going to bring up. Obviously, Stephen King, the king of horror. Not Cujo specifically, but really the ideas in King's universe are some that I really love, and I cherish all of his books, especially some of his earlier works. The Shining is a book that I continuously come back to and reread and think about a lot. And so I think this idea of people being driven by demons that are either inside themselves or in the world around them and the environment around them are definitely things that I put into the Rolston McCain series because the main character, Rolston, he is driven by what he thinks is right but is haunted by the world around him, who he is, his past. And so I think that makes that series comparable to something that Stephen King would write. I'm not saying, for the record, my disclaimer is not that, hey, I am as amazing as these three writers. James Ellroy, James Lee Burke, and Stephen King are definitely my heroes. And so that's the only reason that I bring them up is because I love them and I aspire to be like them, but not that I am them. So those are five things that you now know about me, okay? I was a young writer. I've been trying to write since I was a young kid. I grew up in Georgia. I went to Georgia. I grew up in a small town. I wrote a lot of books, and James Lee Burke, Stephen King, and James Ellroy are my heroes. Look for more emails from me in the coming weeks and months. I try not to spam people's inboxes, but I do want to keep you updated on what I'm doing and who I am. So if you like this, let me know. Send me an email back. Who are your favorite writers? Who do you really love to, you know, on a rainy day, curl up with a good book? Who are those writers? But otherwise, I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you do, let me know. And otherwise, I will see you in the next email. Thank you, and we'll see you on the internet. Bye.